We are going to follow through on what we discussed yesterday about bitachon, having trusted in Hashem. We asked the question, and the question we had asked was a question about, can I have it, can I be a rasha, can I be a wicked person, have trust within Hashem? And we saw a number of sources that seemed to say that, yeah, that actually the fact is, I can, I don't actually have to be totally devoted to God, and yet I can still have bitachon within God. That's what we mentioned yesterday. And we saw from the Kedushas Levi that the concept is the reason why you trust within Hashem is because you don't see anything as a miracle. Once you go into miracle status, then you're asking God to change nature. But if you can look at the world as a non-miracle, as things that have the potential as a non-miracle, then that's the way you're going to get things done, because you have the same equal opportunity as this, as plan A can happen or plan B can actually happen. The Rambam writes as well in the Sefer Mor Nebuchim, how do you translate that? Mor Nebuchim, Guide to the Perplexed. So he writes that, he says the following, Yerali, it seems to me, ki koma shetamtu ra meros halim, all the bad that exists in the world that happens to people, lo metzu harahu rak beis hashikhahi, the only time bad happens to a person is at a time when they forget that a God is in control of everything. The moment they forget and don't see that God is in control of everything, that's when the bad things can happen to a person. And based on the amount of forgetfulness or the gravity of forgetfulness that a person has, that will determine the gravity of evil that can happen to a person. Now, this is always a pausing point, because that pausing point means for us to come to that realization, what about at times as terrible as the Holocaust? We say that it all was based on a person's emunah. So we leave those types of events on the side. Those types of events where there's a general attack overall, that we're leaving aside for a totally different conversation. This point is just saying, to the average individual, on his average day, according to this view of the Rambam, it would seem that if you would see that God is in control of every single thing surrounding you, then there wouldn't be any bad that would actually come upon a person. That's that view. There is a point that's quoted by the Nefesh HaChaim and the Or HaChaim of this point, that when God tells the Jewish people, when they're at the splitting of the sea, right before the sea splits, so they're at the sea, they're at the sea, and right before it splits, he says, Mah Titzakelei, why are you crying out to me? Daber al b'nei Yisrael v'Yisrael, go tell the Jewish people, and let them go through. So the question that is raised is, what do you mean? Aren't I supposed to cry out to you right now? Of course, I'm in prayer. I'm concerned about the sea in front of me. So the answer is that no, you should have enough bitachon, enough trust in God, that He'll figure things out, He'll take care of it. So what is the reason for this? So listen to these words the Or HaChaim says. God is saying, look, I can do a miracle. There's no question that I can do a miracle. but if you're not worthy of a miracle, because of the fact that midas adin, the general sense of judgment upon a person, so you're not actually worthy for that miracle, then I'm not going to enable that miracle to actually happen. So what does he say? He says, speak to the Jewish people and tell them that the way that you're going to be able to get around judgment that's upon you right now that says you're not deserving of a miracle is to overpower that judgment with a form of chesed, with kindness, of receiving kindness from God. And that means, Daber b'nei Yisrael, tell the Jewish people they need to build their faith. Once they build their faith in God at that moment, what they're actually doing is they're asking God for extra kindness upon them. Once they're asking for extra kindness upon them, that is the power to overpower the tzad, the side of judgment that is on the people. And therefore, God's quote-unquote compassionate side will enable the seed to now actually split. Which means God says, the way I'm putting it in nature right now is, seas don't split. It just doesn't happen. But if you work to a point within yourself that you can see God as one who is overpowering in kindness and He wants to give you that kindness, then that can actually change. So that's the way I'm putting it into creation, that I can actually enable it, that I don't want this to happen unless you do something from your side, and I will allow compassion to come about. And by having that bitachon, as he says in his line, ki gadol habitachon, v'amuna halaz l'hachriyam l'tova. By having bitachon, and by having, we said, trust and faith, that will tilt the scales to be in favor of them. So by putting your faith in God during very difficult times, that will be something that actually shifts the tide for us. So this is the view of the Or HaChaim and the Nefesh HaChaim. And one last thing for this evening, and that is the Chavetz Chaim that says the following idea. He says, you should know for yourselves that this quality of bitachon, of trust, is not dependent on your merits. Because even if you're a person that's not really worthy, you're not really worthy of having these great things happen to you, but simply by putting your trust in God, that will be a protection. Not necessarily the gift, but it'll be a protection for you, and that will enable God to give you more chesed, and that is the in the view of the Vilna Gaon as well. And so therefore, according to the view of the Chafetz Chaim, you can actually tilt the tides by putting your faith in God. It is well known, as we mentioned earlier on in the series about this concept, and it's also known that there are many in the Holocaust that also utilize that line of Ein Od Milvado, there's nothing but God, there's nothing but God, in order for them to be saved during horrific times in the Holocaust. So this is something that's been tried and true for generations for people. When a person is going through a difficult time, you say, Hashem Hu Elokim, Hashem is the God, is everything, and Ein Od Milvado, there's nothing but God, and there's nothing that exists besides God, and that itself enables a person to be worthy of salvation, to be protected, or to be saved from many potential dangers.